Hey guys, it's ViewMasters Reactions, and we're back with another trailer reaction. This is trailer number two for Fantasy Island. I had forgotten about this movie. The trailer number one came out a couple months ago. We were talking about whether or not it was related to the original Fantasy Island with Ricardo Montalban and Tattoo. I think it is, loosely, but this is definitely more horror. I also didn't watch a lot of Fantasy Island when it originally aired because it was before my time. I remember reruns coming out all the time, but it wasn't really my thing. It seemed like an adult-type show, and I was, like, really young. So maybe that Fantasy Island got dark and, like, a horror movie, but I don't think that was the case. I'm pretty sure it was, like, a romantic drama or something like that. I could be wrong, but this one is, like, flat-out horror based on the first trailer. It looks like someone's going around murdering people. It almost gives me vibes like there's like a supernatural element on the island, but it's the same type of thing. They fly in, they're greeted like welcome to Fantasy Island. It had Michael Pena as like the host of the island, I guess you'd call him. I also didn't realize it comes out Valentine's Day, so it's 2 weeks away. I'm very interested. I love horror, if you guys know me. I'm curious to see how they do this. The first trailer wasn't bad, but I honestly forgot about it, so it wasn't enough to hold my attention. I have not seen anything on TV as far as promotion or advertising. I think it was Blumhouse, though, so they are a well-known company, but we're just gonna dive in. This is Fantasy Island, trailer number two.
Blumhouse. I'm in a super creepy control room, and I'm about to get this thing started.
It also says the trailer's
a minute long. Congratulations to each of you on winning the contest. And welcome to Fantasy Island.
So, what's your fantasy?
The island tailors each fantasy specifically to the guest. Your life is about to change forever. I hope you're ready. How the island does what it does is a mystery.
It brought her back to life.
The music reminds me of
your fantasy.
Revenge on a childhood bully. The most popular girl in school was my tormentor. Let's have some fun.
Oh my God, that's really her.
This is not what I meant.
The island is twisting our fantasies.
We were brought here to be a part of something else.
Once a fantasy begins, you must see it through.
How is this possible?
That's it, guys. That was a short final trailer. I'm actually shocked that the final trailer is shorter than like a teaser trailer. If you cut out the trailer before the trailer and the end credits, it's like a 45-second trailer, and it's a lot of the same stuff we saw from the first trailer. I don't know if it was in the last one, but they did show in this trailer that she was buddied up with the girl who she was supposed to torture in the other room. It shows her with a bat and her with like a mallet or a sledgehammer. So clearly she lets the girl out, and they probably team up to try to escape, but then it shows a doppelganger of the girl that was tied up, and she's like all cracking and creaky and looks like a demon or some sort of supernatural creature. Michael Pena did say that you have to follow through with your fantasy. So I guess her fantasy was, I want to get back at the ones that bullied me. So she has to torture or bully the girl who tortured or bullied her, but she clearly did not want to. She makes the phone call. She's like, this is not what I signed up for. But Michael Pena just said, you have no choice at this point. So my guess is that they, maybe some people want to follow through and want to torture these people and want to kill these people that traumatized them growing up. But it seems like some of these people are not signed up for this. They're like, wait a second, darker than I thought. Just because someone bullied you or tortured you doesn't mean you're that person. You are more forgiving, maybe, or maybe you just aren't that kind of person. You're not evil. You don't have it in you to hurt somebody. So it looks like that's where this is going. I'm just surprised they didn't do more to like get people like hyped up. There's nothing really in this that wasn't in the first that would hype me up. Like, oh my God, I need to see this now. I'm still going to see it because I dig horror and I'm curious where they're going. There's obviously like a twist or something. I'm pretty sure I said this in the first trailer too, that it has a lot of feels like Us. Now it said from the producers of Get Out and Halloween, Get Out was made by Jordan Peele, who also did Us. But I don't think that was produced by the same people, or it probably would have said produced by the people that did Get Out and Us, not Get Out and Halloween, unless they wanted to branch out and not use two of Jordan Peele's movies and they couldn't throw up every movie that they produced. I don't know. I'm curious. I forget who did Us, but the music and the feels, like just the way the trailer unraveled, gave me a lot of feels like the movie Us that came out earlier last year, I guess now, because it's January. But Still looks really cool. I'm really curious, but nothing that I'm like crazy hyped up about. You guys let me know what you think. You let me know if you noticed anything I didn't catch. But to me, it looks like your typical, I don't want to torture someone and now I got to torture them or I'm going to be tortured kind of movie. I've seen a lot like this, but I'm still intrigued. So let me know what you guys think. Comments down below. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.